I mean, before the murder, there was a certain amount of coordination to cover up what was going on in Malta. The Panama Papers were published in April 2016. My mother was murdered in October 2017. What happened in the interim? Obviously, the fact that Malta featured so extensively in the Panama Papers, we were the only country in the European Union where a sitting cabinet minister was uncovered as having a secret company in Panama, sheltered in a secret trust in New Zealand, was attempting to set up bank accounts all over the world for these secret companies. This caused a huge amount of international embarrassment for Malta. But when we look at government spending, data on government spending, on public relations and advertising and so on, we see a huge increase from 2016 onwards. So at the time, Malta had the presidency of the European Union. The European Union itself had a kind of incentive to look away from what was going on in Malta, because it also wanted to avoid embarrassment. And the government was spending a huge amount of money just on kind of positive advertising about the country. It created this slogan, Blockchain Island, promoting Malta as a kind of paradise for new technologies and innovative finance and so on. It was all just a smokescreen to cover up what was really going on in the country. And after the murder, how did we fight back? By coordinating ourselves. My family worked with NGOs, worked with journalists, a group of international journalists formed something called the Daphne Project, which was coordinated by an organization based in France called Forbidden Stories. We also coordinated with members of parliament from around Europe. 3 months after the murder, in January 2018, my brothers and I went to the Parliamentary Assembly of the Council of Europe and spent 2 days, 3 days, collecting signatures from European parliamentarians to request the appointment of a special rapporteur to look into the circumstances of my mother's murder. So it really took a huge, each step that we took really took a huge amount of coordination.
Thank you. Thank you very much for your contribution.